Yeah.
The so-called Negro community has shot the white man by resisting all efforts to divide us. I think that you and I should continue to shock him by staying and working together in unity. Despite religious, political, economic, or educational, or social differences.
My people are terrified. We've been terrorized to the point that we're mentally and spiritually paralyzed. We suffered through centuries of dehumanization and degradation. It took the form of slavery and segregation in this land of the free, where oppression's government sanctioned. We're subjected to systemic skin color discrimination. From black codes to Jim Crow to black criminalization. It's been 400 years, it's time for our liberation. We're a nation within a nation, victims of colonization. Where's our revolution and Independence Day celebration? Cause what's the 4th of July to the slave on the plantation? And slavery didn't end, they just changed its implementation. Just check the 13th Amendment, then you'll see why so many black males end up as guilty defendants. The system isn't broken, it's working as it's intended. So I'm not here to fix it, I'm here to end it.
And then again, if we tell you that Negroes are being hung on the tree or being shot down illegally, unjustly, and those Negroes should do something to protect themselves, you say you're advocating violence.
I won't rest till this nightmare we're living in ends, and we see justice for our murdered young innocent men. If black lives really matter, black people need the proof. Cause we are the only ones responsible for our improvement. How can we leave it to someone else to do what's best for us? Especially when there's someone else has historically been oppressing us. We can't use a system built to enslave us to free us. And we really sick if we think that they white Jesus can heal us. Our children need us to defend them, teach them and guide them. Show them love and bring out the greatness that is deep inside them. Are we gonna build a nation or stay on the plantation? Keep begging for our freedom or fight for our liberation?
When the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, he didn't say get nonviolent. He said praise the Lord, but pass the ammunition.
We must be willing to die together or we'll definitely die separately. We desperately need unity if liberation is our destiny. If we don't know our history, then we doomed to repeat it. White supremacy is the enemy, but together we can defeat it. They stole us from the motherland, sold us into slavery, forced us to work for them. They got the nerve to call us lazy. In this caste system, we're outcasts, still treated as second class. But I can feel it in the air, revolutions in the forecast. We came for greatness, but they don't want us to know. So they hid our history to keep us under control. All it takes is to take a stand. The enemy's not invincible, but we must come together as one nation in the visible.
20 million black people don't even know their own language. Why? Because he took it away from them. 20 million black people who don't even know the history of their ancestors. Why? Because he took it away from them. And if he's trying to tell them how thoroughly and completely they've been robbed, he says to teach his hate. You're coming out of the leading university. You're trying to go in a good direction, but you don't know which direction to go in.